This next primetime program, upon completion, is being whisked off to the Museum of Broadcasting for archival purposes. It's that good. Where it always smells like fresh popcorn, it's Primetime with George Gurunda. Tonight, we go behind the scenes here at Showcase Cinemas with John Lowe, and George gets his picture on his official TV host mug, plus reflection. So get ready for the most entertaining show on television. Hi, I'm George Gurunda, and welcome to Primetime. Let me tell you folks what a power-packed show we have for you here tonight, because we're here at Showcase Cinemas. We're going to be going behind the scenes a little later on in the program. But, you know, for all you kids watching, Doug wants, he's an aspiring superstar. And if you wonder how to get into show business, I think I have the answer. Now, here's what you do. Get yourself on one of those hour and a half Oprah specials. That's the key. That's the key right there. Get yourself an hour and a half with Oprah and your career is gonna skyrocket. But another way is to get your face on an official TV host mug. So let's head over to the Big E and we'll take care of that right now.
So tell me, we can get our picture on anything, right?
Well, we have buttons, keychains.
What was that noise?
That means something's ready.
Something's ready. Well, we'll pull it out. If it's ready, pull it out.
What do we got? We got a keychain of a couple.
We got a keychain of a couple.
There they are. And we do mugs.
We do mugs.
Yeah, and we do the big posters. You want to see them?
Giant posters.
Right here.
Giant sized posters.
Look at those four kids on that poster. So, pretty good, huh?
So I can have a mug or a poster or anything.
That's right. We also got pins.
We also have pins.
Yeah.
What's the most popular?
This year it seems like the keychains are.
The keychains are.
Yeah, that's our new item. They like that. When you get a couple up here, the girl and the boy together, they both get one, so it's a good product.
I've always liked mugs myself
because
I always enjoy a lovely beverage.
What kind?
I ask the questions because I'm the host.
Oh, okay.
So can we do a mug here?
You sure can.
What do I have to do? Where do I have to stand?
Right in here.
We sit right in here. Inside the sunset.
Uh-huh. All right, looking good. Here we go.
Hey.
And now you got to pick out a saying for your mug. Okay?
Oh, we have sayings.
They all read something different. This one says, when you want the best, call me. Does that suit you?
That suits me because I'm the best.
Okay.
So how long is this whole thing going to take?
It takes about 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, and it'll be ready just like
that. There you go.
So it's just like magic. I told you, just like that.
Yeah, it says, when you want the best, call me. Is that your mug?
Nothing could be more true. You know me, huh?
No, I don't.
Well, you picked the
Pretty
right
nice.
Saying.
Yeah, that is a nice saying, isn't it, huh?
Nobody does it better.
The forest is home to many living things. That's why, if you're careless with fire when you go to the forest, you could burn a lot more than trees.
Yes, well, we're here at Showcase Cinemas. We're back again, and time to go see a movie. We have to get some snacks here. And Doug, what do you want? You want some popcorn? You want some Junior Mints? Doug?
What you like?
Doug, what are you doing here? I mean, what'd you do with Kevin? He's supposed to be serving some snacks here, and you're supposed to be running camera.
He's in the Bat Cave.
In the Bat Cave? Well, you better get him out of the Bat Cave, because he has to work here. Fred's going to get mad at him. He's going to fire everybody. And what are you doing in this ridiculous outfit?
I'm Batman.
Doug.
Yeah, George?
Take your hands off me.
Oh. Damn, I hate it when it does that.
Well, popcorn, and I certainly enjoy popcorn. And let's go behind the scenes with John Lowe and see exactly how they make the popcorn here at Showcase Cinemas.
Well, John, always a pleasure to have you here on the big program. You know what my favorite aspect of movie going is? Popcorn. And I understand there are myths that you do not pop your popcorn. People see it in the yellow bags, but we know different. You actually have a couple of popping rooms here.
Years ago, and this goes back to the 40s, there was usually a theater like the Calvin in Northampton. Right aside of the Calvin was a place called Denny Clifford's, which was a little soda fountain, spa type thing where you buy ice cream, and they sold books and magazines there. And they had even a lending library, 2 cent a day lending library with the latest novels. But anyway, he had a popcorn machine there. And he used to pop popcorn. And for a dime, I think it was, you would buy a bag of popcorn in a glassine bag, very small bag. And we had the theater there, not we here, but Goldstein, Western Mass Theaters. And we couldn't sell popcorn at the theater. In fact, we didn't sell anything at the theater except a little candy stand. The candy stand was a little piano.
Was there a reason for this?
Well, because that was the way the lease was for the store, for his store.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, we had a candy stand, which was just like a piano, an upright piano. And at night, you just closed the two wings on it and closed the top down, and that was it. The two candy girls on a Saturday night stood in front of the candy stand, stood in front of the piano, I call it, and sold you the candy. Candy was a nickel candy bar, 10-cent candy bar, and a 25-cent bag of Kemp's salted nuts or mixed cashew nuts. We sold cigarettes there, and we sold Lifesavers for a nickel, and that was it. Later on, we had a soda machine. Now, the soda machine was not a bottle machine. It was a little drink came out in a cup, and it was a nickel. And it was three different flavors, Coke, root beer, and orange. And that took care of the entire 1,876 seat customers that came to that theater at the Calvin in Northampton.
Were there lines at this machine?
Yes, there were always lines at the machine. But anyway, in those days, you could not take ice cream into the theater. He sold ice cream next door, but you could, in fact, we had two ice cream stores, one on each side. The Calvin ice cream made their own ice cream. You couldn't take ice cream unless you take ice cream in the theater. And you couldn't take your drink into the theater. You had to drink it by the machine. So anyway, things changed, and we developed our own popcorn that we bought, made from Springfield, and it was shipped up. And that's where the myth came about that most theaters never popped their own popcorn. But to avoid that myth, we all put in our own little popcorn machines at the stand. So at the stand, when you went in, you saw a popcorn machine and someone popping popcorn. And of course, the smell of that drove you crazy, and you had to stop and get some popcorn.
Now today here, we don't see people popping at the stands, but it is fresh popped popcorn
every day. We pop
corn
all the time at 11 to 14 across the street and over here in 1 to 10. And we go through bags and bags and bags of corn when we're busy.
How much do you go through in a busy day?
That would be like a military secret. I think I would get shot if I told you that.
Does that vary depending on whether or not I'm here to see a movie?
Yes. We notice there's a big increase when you come. But we sell ice cream. Some of our theaters are selling coffee now. We're selling hot dogs at some of the theaters. We're selling a small special type pizza at some of our theaters. They're constantly trying to find things that will be saleable, that will be easy to handle, easy to work with.
Something to enhance the movie going experience.
The people want it, frankly. The people want it and are looking for it. We sell promotional t-shirts from time to time. We sell movie posters from time to time. We sell souvenir books from the film. We sell MTV calendars. We sell MTV cups. And these are usually tied in with a promotion. We are own National Amusements, that owns the theaters, owns Viacom and MTV and the Movie Channel and Showtime. And Sumner Redstone is in charge of the whole conglomerate. And so we do try to work with MTV and their various promotional things from time to time. And that's why you'll see some of these new things in our stand. But the public finds it very desirable to have big size drinks, big size popcorn, big size candy bars. And the theaters in the past used to get criticized for selling a candy bar that you could buy at CVS or you could buy somewhere else cheaper. So across the country, they are now making what they call theater packs, which are a special, bigger size candy bar that are sold only at theaters. A bigger size of a name brand candy bar that are sold at theaters. Hershey's, for example, does that. Mars does that. Every major company that sells candy now makes a theater pack exclusively for theaters.
So you could not find these products anywhere else.
That's right.
And you will very shortly be having hot dogs here?
Well, we don't know. We're doing them in Hartford right now. What they do is we have about 85 locations here in the United States and another 10 over in England. And they, through our concession department, will try an item here and an item there and an item in five or six of our locations, various demographic locations, various geographical locations, and see if it's successful. And if it is, then they bring it out a little bit further into another 20 theaters. And that's how they do it, because it's very risky, because what goes one place doesn't necessarily go in another place. So they could very well wind up with stuff that they were trying to push down theater people's throats. So we just do it very slowly, very carefully, and it's been very successful. That's how we've started a lot of new things, particularly big size different drinks. So that's worked out very well. But popcorn is part of going to a movie. You wouldn't watch a movie without popcorn.
It's like going to a caterer's banquet without food, right?
That's right. You couldn't go. You couldn't enjoy it.
You do use canola oil?
Yes, we use a canola oil that is a new product that we've just started about a year ago. And that's been very successful. It's much tastier, and it is nutritionally better for you. Popcorn is one of the best nutritional foods you can ever get. And every once in a while, we go into these little...
Especially when you put all that extra butter on.
No. So anyway, the soda, too. We switched over to Pepsi about a year and a half ago from Coca-Cola. And Pepsi has been a very promotion-minded company. And as a result, we've had all of these Pepsi Cola contests and Pepsi Cola giveaways and things like that. And that's worked out very well. So our increase in sales has been very, very good. Our whole goal is to get you to spend more on the stand, not by raising prices. We are very careful about competitive prices on popcorn, soda, and candy, as I explained to you about the candy, because it's very important that people don't feel they're being taken advantage of. We're trying a new thing in Hartford called Pick a Mix, which is a series of plastic dishes on the side wall, and you go up to them and you put your little shovel in and take out some things and take out different candy. We have 25 different candies there, and you put them in a little bag, and then you take it over to the person and weigh it, and you're helping
so
yourself to your own candy.
You'll pay and get the selection you want, and,
yes.
And pay by the pound for what you're getting.
Yes. Yeah, pay by the pound, quarter pound, half pound, whatever way you want, whatever way you do. And it's been very successful. We've been doing that now for about 3 months, and it's just building up all the time. The people like it because they can get more of what they want in one thing, and they have this wonderful feeling about being able to be their own master, so to speak. And there's a tremendous selection of stuff there in the counter. It's worked out good. One of our newest successes, you might say.
A new innovation. Continuing our tour behind the scenes, sort of, here in this segment, What is the screen material actually made of?
Well, the screen material right now is a plastic sheet perforated with millions of little holes in it for the sound to come through. And it's washable. A screen lasts usually about 3 or 4 years, and it can be washed, they say, once or maybe twice, and then it has to be replaced. So we have a system of replacing screens about every 4 years. They cost an average of $2,000 to put up a new screen. They're tailor-made to the size of the auditorium, to the style of the auditorium, to the general width of the auditorium. Each screen has a different reflective type quality, whether it's a matte screen or a special lenticular type screen. It's quite a job to know which screen to put in. We have people come up from Boston that's all they do, go around the whole country putting in screens and putting new masking in and new adjustable drapes and things like that.
Now, in the projection booths, most people at home expect to see the old reels, and we don't use those anymore. We now have...
They're on platters. A platter is, the film comes to us in reels, and it is mounted together, spliced together onto a big platter. And that platter goes up, across, down through the projector, and in to another platter, where it automatically rewinds itself. It's rewound as it's coming through. Then the operator just threads it up again and goes right through, and it winds up on the next platter. So in other words, it's a completely automated type thing, except for threading up the projectors.
And the theater lights going up and down are all completely automated?
On the film itself, the operator puts some little silver tinfoil pieces, which automatically triggers the mechanism, which says the lights go up when this piece of tinfoil goes through, the lights go up, the lights go down, the music stops, the music plays, and whatever. It's all done by the operator in his preparation and mounting the film together, what we call mounting it together.
Now, you have one operator who may service several theaters.
That's right.
What happens if the film breaks? Is there a safety?
Oh, yes, of course. If the film ever broke, the projector shuts down, the screen lights go up, the house lights go on, and the buzzer buzzes to notify everybody. So there's no problem with that. All of our managers are licensed operators also, so that we have an operator in each building all the time.
And are there different types of lenses depending on whether
you're
using...
Yes, we have, if you're playing a CinemaScope picture, we have CinemaScope lenses that had to be put on for that, and what we call a flat picture. A scope picture, as you know, is long and wide, and the flat picture is more square. So that's all done by the operator ahead of time.
Now, we mentioned before about running the same film in two adjacent theaters.
Right.
You do not necessarily have to get two prints of that movie. I understand there's something called interlock.
Yeah. Lately, they've been sending us two prints on a picture, but occasionally we have, in some of our theaters, are equipped side-by-side theaters equipped with an interlock mechanism, which enables us to run the one print in two theaters by a series of rollers. The film comes off the platter the same way and goes through the projector. And instead of going back into the bottom platter, it goes across a series of rollers to the other projector and then through to the bottom platter. So what it means, it enables us to take a picture that's very successful and run it in two theaters for a particular showing, enabling us not to have to have a second print if the film company hasn't had a second print available for us. And there's a delay of about 30 seconds, so you could actually go into this theater and see the 20th Century Fox trademark.
And run into the other theater.
Well, you wouldn't have to run.
You
walk into the other theater and see the 20th Century Fox trademark. Or you could go back and see the same dance number twice if you wanted to. Not quite.
Almost. If you were quick.
Yes, if you were quick.
I understand across the street, 11 and 14 are interlocked, and that is one of the longest interlocked
runs. 11 and 12 are interlocked, and 13 and 14 are intact.
But there's the back two are the ones that that is the
they're
longest.
Intact. Yeah, that's one of the longest
run in the country.
Yeah, that one. Well, there are longer ones than that too, because we have some new theaters that have been built that are 8 and 10 plexes in one long row. See, these are all built in sections, so to speak, but there are 8 and 10 theaters in one long row. The booth is as long as this. It's 150 feet booth, long booth. Mm-hmm. And you can almost see the other end of the projectors. And we have interlocks that'll go that length by a series of rollers. There's no real reason to do it, but it can be done.
Usually you would interlock the two nearest projectors.
Yes, right. That's right.
But
it can be done.
It can be done.
Yeah, almost anything can be done now. I always say to the kids at the theater, I say, we went to the moon. I don't know why we can't do this. And that's one of our slogans. But the movie business is fascinating because there are so many people that want to know so much about the movie business, making movies, the stars, the gossip, the history, how to write a film, how to write for film, how to direct. Years ago, there was only 2 to 4 books a year put out on movies. Now there's probably 6 books a week on movies. There was no film schools. There was 2 film schools, 3 film schools in the 40s, UCLA, USC, and NYU. Now there's probably, I would say, over 150 schools that teach film in some form, enabling you to get a BA degree in fine arts. There are schools for writing, schools for directing, schools for photography, schools for editing. And if you figure that every bit of film you see on television, someplace along the line was film, and every piece of film in the theater that you see is film, and every training film you see at work is film. There's a lot of filmmakers that are going to be making film in the years to come.
And hopefully for many, many years to come. And hopefully the folks at home had a chance to get a glimpse behind the scenes here.
Of the movie business.
Of the movie business. John, thanks once again for being here. You're welcome back anytime. And you folks stick around. We'll be back with more of the big program right after this.
What are you doing this weekend that's so important you can't take a little time to test your home for radon? After all, it is the second leading cause of lung cancer, and a radon test kit is inexpensive. You could pick one up on your way to get a few things for the yard.
Yes, welcome back to the big program. And you know, for you Red Sox fans, Red Sox season tickets are now available. And I understand they're running some magnificent bargains. Something like buy one season ticket, get one free. Buy 2 season tickets, and you get to play third base. Hey, but somebody who's never on third base, yes, it's the lovely and talented Jeannie here to perform with Reflection, Save the Best for Last.
Sometimes the snow comes down in June. Sometimes the sun goes round the moon. I see the passion in your eyes. Sometimes it's all a big surprise. 'Cause there was a time when all I did was wish you'd tell me this was love. It's not the somehow, yeah. Isn't this world a crazy place? Just when I thought our chance had passed, you go and save the best for last. All of the nights you came. Isn't this world a crazy place? Just when I thought our chance had passed, you go and save the best for last. La 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 la. Sometimes the very thing you're looking for is the one thing you can see. Sometimes the snow comes down in June. Sometimes the sun goes round the moon. Just when I thought our chance had passed, you go and save the best. You went and saved the best for last. Yeah.
Yes, well, that just about wraps up another show here on Primetime. It's time for the movie to start. Ernie's ready up in the projection booth. Doug, why don't you join me for the movie? We have our big bags of popcorn and we have plenty of snacks. What could be better? A movie and snacks. Hey, thanks to everyone here at Showcase Cinemas. It was another perfect show. Good night, everyone.
Don't let a forest